About the last 5 years.
About 2 years, actually, Chris.
Well, Hey, you know what? Let me say one thing. In that game, how many sacks did I have that we came back and won?
How many sacks did you
have? How many sacks?
This was back in 1989.
Okay, that was about
you didn't even been Jim Everett back there, but somewhere along the way, Jim, you ceased being Jim and you became Chris.
Well, let me tell you a little secret. That, you know, we're sitting here right now, and if you guys want to take a station break, you can. But if you call me Chris Everett to my face one more time,
I already did it twice.
We better take a station break.
Well, it's a 5-minute segment, our 5-segment show. We got a long way to go.
Well, we do.
We got a long way to go.
We do.
I'll get a couple segments out of you
for. Good to be here with you, though.
Well, it's good to see you
because you've been talking like this behind my back for a long time.
But now I said it right here.
Right. Exactly.
Well, we got no problem.
Well, I think that you probably won't say it again.
I bet I do.
Okay.
Chris.
When the dust has settled, Holmes continued with the show minus Everett. For his part, Everett apologized, saying the frustrations of his time in Los Angeles came to a head with the repeated taunt of the host, and he won. Thank you.
seat, please, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to summarize for you the meeting that I have just had with the bipartisan leaders, which began at 8 o'clock and was completed 2 hours later. I began the meeting by making this statement, which I think needs to be made to the nation. America's public enemy number one in the United States is drug abuse.
This is awesome.
Peter, I'm freaking out.
Don't ruin it for me.
I come from the wasteland. I got a wide wingspan. I'm kind of tall, so I got a wild wingspan. Enough about me. Let's talk about the weather. Rain out here only makes things better out here. In the capital waste, there's big scary monsters that'll eat your face. So you better be running at a breakneck pace. Cause this motherfucker's got 16 legs. Want a place to hide? Make sure you got cover. Cause this behemoth is one tough mother.
Thank you. Drug dealers need to know that we want them out of our schools, neighborhoods, and our lives. And the only way to do that is to take the customers away from the product. Say no to drugs and say yes to life.
Parents who use drugs have children who use drugs. Who taught you how to do this stuff?
You, all right? I learned it by watching you.
I get angry just Anything about it makes me mad. Little kids doing drugs, it turns my stomach.
Hey, kiddies, gather around. The man with the goodies is here. Here's a little beauty for me to Udy. Just inhale and sniff at his aeroplane blue. Oh, one whiff, man.
Isn't it true that sniffing glue can damage your liver and kidneys?
Cool, kid. Look here. Amphetamine. Any sexy mess.
They say amphetamines can cause something like schizophrenia.
Schizophrenia, in most cases, it does not last. Cool, kid. Now for the bar. Neato night. Get down it.
Withdrawal from barbiturates can cause convulsions.
You can pull yourself out of here. Where? Anything wrong with pot?
They're not sure yet. They just started studying about it.
Well, reward. Dig, everybody. L-F-D.
Bad trips and a chance of chromosome damage.
How do you know you got some?
Everything you got there can hurt you, can't it?
Sure, kid. Why do you think they call it so?
Nah.
Hey, where's everybody going?
Of course, the local drug pusher may tell you a little something different about these drugs. And who you believe is up to you. Then again, if you go ahead and try them, at least it won't be out of ignorance. Just stupidity. What would I do if someone offered me these drugs?